All right, Boyd, talk to me about this. So this is a pretty straightforward ruling. Justice Samuel Alito said the only question before us is whether Ohio's law violates federal law. It does not. He went on to say, it is undisputed that Ohio does not remove a registrant on change of residence grounds unless the registrant is sent and fails to mail back a return card and then fails to vote for an additional 4 years. Boyd, what is the basis of the liberal argument that this disenfranchises voters?
I think it's just a liberal talking point at this point, because if you look at what the justices were trying to do, they're trying to square two laws. The 1993 law, which says that no voter should have any undue, you know, pressure or inability to vote. It can't be that hard to vote. And then the second is the 2000 law that says we need to purge to make sure we have security and that we have consistency in terms of our database so we can make sure there's no fraud or abuse of the system. And so all the justices did was square those two things in terms of making sure that people have a right to vote and it's easy to do, and then also that we're purging those who have died, those who have gone to prison, those who are no longer eligible to vote. And when you look at what they're trying to do, I mean, there are 24 million voter files in the United States that are either completely inaccurate or dominantly inaccurate. So there's one part of the problem. You also have 2.7 million people who are registered to vote in two states, which when we talk about having integrity of our election system is a pretty big deal. And so I think what the justices were simply trying to do is say, look, and this is not a burdensome process, really. I mean, if you miss voting in 2 years in a row, you don't respond, you still have four more years to get it right. 6 years, I think that's plenty of time for people to, if they've moved, if they've changed, if whatever's happened, that's plenty of time to deal with it. So I'm not sure why everyone's breathlessly running around as if this is going to, you know, be some sort of infringement or discrimination.
Right. Well, I can tell you why. It's because all those people that are registered in two states, all those people that are registered incorrectly or registered after they die, Democrats want those people on the voter rolls because it makes it easier for voter fraud. It makes it easier for people to cast votes that they shouldn't be casting to swing elections. I mean, I know it sounds terrible, and some people say, listen, that's a conspiracy allegation, but look, there's evidence that this type of voter fraud does happen. I actually commend Ohio for taking seriously the integrity of each person's vote, because when you have that high number of voter registrations that are invalid and you don't have a voter ID law to ensure that the people coming into the...
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.